Now we have the last speaker of the day, who is Daniele Bertacca from Padova, and he will talk about the impact of Litecoin and wine angle effects and other things. Many other things. Please.
Thank you very much for inviting me to have an opportunity to give a kick off of this topic. Interesting, useful also for the future surveys. Let me start with a very short historical start. Of course, from the 90s, the catalogs constantly increased both for the solid angle and the register. Then we can cover, when we see the future surveys, very large volumes. And in particular, considering very huge volumes, that here there are some examples, we need to take into account several facts that probably is missed in the standard analysis. Indeed, the standard description is the Newtonian one. And the idea, when you consider very huge volumes, very large surveys, then we need to add the GR corrections, not only for the using Einstein equations, but also the projection effects for the geodesic for the galaxies. Okay. And maybe there are other effects that maybe we could measure and observe and make constraints. I give you a few examples. For example, for wrong predictions at very, very large scales, I'm going to discuss also this point for the Doppler terms, of course, the non-Gaussianity, high order corrections, for example, second order, of course, constraints that matter dark energy, and maybe also modify gravity models, constraints neutrino, curvature, and now I added another effect that I'm going to explain the second part of the talk, is the finger of the observer or Kaiser-Rock effects, depends on the literature. Okay. Of course, we need to identify correctly the density contrast, that it is unique and gauge invariant because it is what we are observing. And need to reconstruct correctly the path light cone. And historically, we have several effects, for example, resistance distortions, bias, mathematically and physically, and magnification bias in order to add all possible effects. The point is that they added in ad hoc way, but the crucial point that we need to build a core prescription and a unified treatments in order to add correctly all the effects. Of course, the first one is, for example, related to the peculiar velocity of our galaxies, that we see in these figures, we have a clear imprint two-point correlation functions, for example. And for example, starting from the Z related to homogeneous entropic universe, it's an assumption, of course, and then the observed one, that what we are really observing, and then we can reconstruct, for example, making a shift, for example, for the peculiar velocity. The idea, starting from Kaiser, and then there is a very nice review of Hamilton that try to explain clearly away this point. They have a bunch of real space, and then due to the shift, due to the peculiar velocities, that here I give this shift, we're able to map from the observed frame and the real one, for example, related to simulations, for example. And of course, a crucial point that of course, it's conserved the number of objects. This is the n is moving one. Okay. Making this shift, making the correct the Jacobian, there is one term. This is the essential term that is very popular, is related to the fact and crucial term that Kaiser worked and then is crucial for the make observations. Then there are others that we need to take into account, and adding at linear order, because we are considering all scales at very large scales at the moment. And this is the final relation. In this case, there is This term is related to the peculiar velocity along line of sight, and then it is the Kaiser term. And then there is the peculiar velocity term, Doppler term, that have a particular imprint also the distribution of the objects along line of sight, that in principle we should consider. Indeed, in general literature, this term is we can neglect, also mainly for small scales or smaller scales. Instead, when we consider very large scales, this term that I'm expressed here is a comparable of the Kaiser one. And then in principle, you should consider. In general, when you neglect this term, this is the standard prescription. For example, you come to the two-point correlation function made for your transformations. And this is the standard prescription. And this is related, this F is related to growth. And thanks to this is crucial because thanks to this, we are able to make crucial measurements for the expansion of the universe, the perturbation theory, and so on. This is an example instead, if at very low ratios, how much is important is this alpha term. This is the case, the standard case when alpha is equal to zero. And here is case when alpha is around five. Of course, this is the BO peak. Beyond, it's clear that it's quite different. And then when you consider very large scales, necessarily you need to consider also this effect. Now, in literature, also Kaiser and Hamilton, they consider a service at very low ratio. In particular, they consider this term here, stress, that there is in this shift, in general, people set H to D. In reality, it's wrong. Mainly when you consider redshifts, for example, for very huge volume, also for Euclid survey or SKA, where the redshift is very different. And then when you add this term, this is very important, there is not only the related term that Kaiser pointed out, but there is also this term that you have to add. It is very pretty, this term, because you depends on the age along line of sight. And this age is related to the expansion of the universe. And then probably you could consider also this effect. And this is the standard alpha term that Hamilton pointed out. Adding this term, we are able also to make new constraints, mainly thanks of this term, in principle, of course. Then there's also another term that added here is related to the velocity of the observer that in general we neglect. And this term, I think, is very important, also we'll discuss later, the second part of the talk, and that maybe we are able to do new constraints, maybe also for Laskin structure and also expansion of the universe. Of course, there is also the issue of the bias, because when you consider a very large case, you need to consider the correct frame to set the bias. And the correct one when the spherical, the collapse of the matter, no? Matter and baryons and galaxies, no? That the galaxy traces the baryons and the matter. And in this case, we need to connect correctly in this frame that should be the co-moving one. And setting correctly this frame, we can clearly, at very large scale, at very narrow at the moment, to set the real space, the density contrast in this frame, what we observe in a catalog. Another important point is the magnification bias. In particular, metric perturbations alters the solved angle. In this pretty picture, we can see clearly that the faint galaxies, thanks to the lensing, for example, we are able to detect and then increase. And then we need to take into account also this effect, mainly when you consider the flux cut of the distribution of the objects along the line of sight, and necessarily you need to consider also this effect. This effect is related to the area of the image that you are considering. You can rewrite mathematically in GR, and you add the extra terms. One is the Lansing term that I pointed out before, but it is also peculiar velocity. One term is well known, is the aberration. The other is a relative to the peculiar velocity. Okay, but let me stress that this term is completely neglected. In this case, we consider the density construct without magnification, and then you add the magnification in this way. Okay. And this Q is related to this the bias magnification that you can set for distribution of objects along nanos. Now, as also Cora pointed out, we need to set up a correct frame. And then, as the same definition that Cora pointed out, is the cosmic laboratory. The cosmic laboratory is what really you are observing. In particular, you have the galaxy along line of sight, you have a redshift. Okay? Of course, you need a model in order to consider to reconstruct the comoving density. But assuming a model, you are able to reconstruct with a catalog the angle and the comoving distance. However, you need to consider the universe that is not homogeneous isotropic, also at very large scales. And then you, through the geodetic deviation, make a perturbation of geodetic deviation at very large scales, need to set up a correct map from the real frame to the observer. In this case, the shift is not only related to the space part that people considered until now, but also in time, and build the Lycon correctly. In this case, here I give just only a list of the objects. There are a potential, the observed velocity, Saxwell term, ISW, that is related to potential along line of sight that depends on the time, and so on. If you add this prescription, necessary, you need to consider the correct frame to confine GR, no? the number density. And then you can start the gauge invariant quantity and do perturbation and do the, use this map. And then you have extra terms related to redshift and the volume. In this case, we have in particular three terms. The first one is related to redshift phase distortion that also I mentioned, I considered also before, and also potential terms. And then in this case, the density and over density have a particular squid distribution, for example, for over density, for example. And of course, for the void is completely opposite. Then there is integral terms along line of sight, for example, the Lansing term. And then other terms that you have to integrate along line of sight related to ISW and time Shapiro delay. Now, using this prescription, it's interesting to see the alpha term. In this case, we have extra terms that, for example, is very pretty to see that the curve velocity and the velocity of the server have different definition of alpha. Indeed, this alpha is related to the Doppler term. In this case, it depends on the magnification bias, evolution bias, and also the term that I pointed out before. Instead, the alpha related to the observed one, we have the first term the same, that it is related to a direction, and the second term is different. This is very important because it could help to break some degeneracies and to use this info to extract cosmological information through the galaxy and catalogs. This is the evolution bias that I also pointed out before I defined with the comoving distance. Now this is defined in redshift, and then there is also magnification bias, because the distribution of the objects is setted with the flux cut limit. In this case, it's very pretty also to define alpha in different way. The first step, that it is the usual one that also Kaiser pointed out. Then there is the Doppler term that is written here. And then there is a deceleration term that depends on omega. That is very important. Now, in particular, you can add the calculation in an order mathematically, you can, but the crucial point is to use simulations from CAD, that from a particular experiment, Euclid, Roman experiment, DESI, and to use these simulations and add these collegial effects. And what when I was born in Germany, the idea is to add all these corrections at very large scales. In particular, we started with the Newtonian simulations. We selected the observer, we shift and add the magnification and extract the light cone. For example, as you see, that we needed a potential. Often there is not this potential term when you consider an body simulation. In this case, we have to build a grid, build a potential, extract this info, and in order to extract the light cone correctly along line of sight. Let me stress here, because in the very last case, is just we can use the Born approximation. When you consider nonlinear scales, you need to go beyond, of course. And then we add all this stuff that I said before, the Kaiser term, we can extract the Kaiser term, the Doppler term, all the effects related to lensing, volume distortion, ISW, sexual perfect. This is an example. This is the standard real simulation, for example. Here, adding all the effects or standard peculiar velocity along line of sight. And then here, this is adding a magnification. Now, let me give you two examples. One case in order to extract the magnification bias, and the second is to extract the Doppler term. The good thing that when you add this type of mocks and simulation, you can add any effect that you like in order to see if actively this effect is important. Okay. In one case, we add the standard, we add all GR effects, for example, and then we add, for example, magnification, just magnification related to lensing term. And then we also consider the only case when there is a Kaiser and Doppler term. And then we try to extract all info. In particular, for example, in this type of analysis, we come to angular point correlation functions. For example, for a particular survey, we split in different bins in redshift, no? and we come to autocorrelation across. The cross is crucial, for example, for the lensing, of course. For example, this is what I said before. Here, for the autocorrelation for the last bin, in redshift. This is the cross with the first bin and the last bin. This is the analysis without the lensing. Here, when you construct the magnification, and then we see clearly that this analysis is correct, and we are able to extract the magnification with around sigma to noise around 8. Another example is related to extract the Doppler term. In general, people neglect completely this part, let me stress. And we consider two cases, one when we have all GR effects, and the second when we suppress the evolution and magnification bias, and then consider just on the shift peculiar velocity, okay? Then we consider, in particular, a case when a survey at low redshift, because as I pointed out before, you need a low redshift in order to extract the peculiar velocity. And then we consider a bin and two sub-bins. In particular, what we did is to consider two types of flux. In this case, you have two types of magnification bias, two types of two different evolution bias. In general, when you do this correlation, the sigma to noise is around one. Then you cannot do nothing. But when you consider two types of two tracers and consider the McDonald's-Jacques prescription, in particular, we consider for one bean the one trace. The second bean for another trace minus opposite. In this case, we can remove a lot of noise, and then we are able to extract this signal. And then we can reach until around the five. That is, I think, is huge result, for my opinion. This is, but in principle, you can do what you want, Raul, but it's crucial at low ratio. At low ratio, yes. This is very pretty, I think. But we do more. We use also the Fourier transformation of two-point correlation function and compute the monopole. The reason why the monopole, because when you consider a very large case, it's not clear what is the directional of line of sight. And if you use the monopole, we are able to have the correct result in this case. Okay, because if you consider higher multiples, is tricky, the interpretation of the Fourier transformation. This is trivial because when you consider Fourier, should be Fourier one case, another case, and then you need a map for these two K, for these two kappa. Instead, when you consider the monopole, in some sense, we are able to extract correctly the power spectrum, and then we are able to see the nearer one that we can extract in the standard analysis when you do the Fourier transformations. Here we see that the standard multi power spectrum. Let me stress this is a particular catalog in different beans. We add the window function, then there are all types of analysis that you need to consider in a survey. And here there is the standard P of K after the convolution of the window function. And then here there is all the line related to with all the other corrections. Here, let me stress the main term here is the lensing. Okay. And we see clearly that the signal is completely different respect to the standard analysis. Now, let me stress again the second part of the talk related to dipole, okay, in particular, the velocity of the observer. In particular, there are two types of signal. One is related to structure formation. The second is related to kinetic dipole. That, of course, is related that you have to add all possible velocity from CMB frame, co-moving frame, the end until the observer. Then you have to add the velocity of the Milky Way, the local group, and reconstruct the velocity. Okay. In particular, one of the idea was to reconstruct this velocity with like a structure, okay? And of course, one thing that we can do that you have the observer, you have all galaxies around you, and then using the overdensity, you are able to reconstruct the velocity of the observer. Here we are considering a linear one because when you need a small but large enough in order to have the linear theory, of course. Of course, the crucial point that I would like to stress that this local group velocity, for example, that using this prescription, is a result of cumulative gravitational pull of the surrounding distribution of the matter in the universe. Okay. Important thing that if this average and the radius of this average is large enough, you are able to, in principle, to recover the velocity of the CMB1 that we are able to extract with, for example, with the Planck. But let me stress important point that people try to consider this, but unless of huge error, probably related to the not only to consider the kinetic term, but also related to the structure formation that add you a noise, crucial noise that in principle you are not able to reconstruct correctly the velocity. But there is a pretty thing. This type of velocity that we are able to reconstruct, in particular for a two-point correlation function, there is this extra term that also I pointed out before. This term is also related to the distribution of objects along the site that could add an extra signal and amplify the signal. Okay. In this case, using the standard analysis, and then you add the velocity of the observer, no? As also pointed out before, there is this new correction, and this alpha that also I defined before, that depends on the magnification and the evolution bias, and H along line of sight. This term in literature, you can see also kinetic dipole, in particular when you come to two-point correlation function, people, when you set C equal to 1, L equal to 1, or Kaiser rocket effect, and then you can see here why is rocket effect. And also in literature, people also called also finger observer. Here, for example, for two-point correlation function, here the standard analysis, this is the BOP. This is the green line is original corrections. And here also I added also the velocity of the observer. Here is almost constant because the angle is very small. But in principle, you start at constant and then you have a bump. Indeed, thanks of this particular feature, if you want to compute in Fourier space, we have this strange oscillation. At very, very large scales. Indeed, if you have a bin in redshift thin enough, in principle, you are able to reconstruct and model this particular feature. For example, you can see immediately that is related to J1 square. Okay. And then you can use this info because within this alpha, there are all info that I pointed out here. Here is adding a Liger, this is a simulation adding OGR effects. This is the standard analysis for different beams. Here, when you add the GR corrections that I pointed out before, and this is this pink line, is the first part of that oscillation. And you see clearly that the signal explodes. But in reality, it's not true, because if you see clearly that it is bam and then go to zero, of course, must be. Okay. And then here that when you have all beams all together, you clearly see that this signal is huge. And if we are able to see this signal, we are able to have a new way to measure, for example, expansion of the universe. There is another point that we discussed that in principle, we are in the frame of SEPA, of course, but in principle, we can move to the CMB frame, the co-moving frame. In general, the standard analysis is to correct the redshift. In reality, this is wrong for two motivations. The first, because of course there is aberration. But if you correct the aberration that the people with supernova considering this effect, there is an extra term related to magnification. And then this signal that I pointed out before, there is still there. Okay, but we can do more. Using this signal, we can, for example, starting from the CMB velocity to measure evolution bias or magnification bias, or starting from the standard cosmology that we defined before, we are able to construct the VOBS in different way, completely different way. More ambitious, using the finger observer, we can also proprio the cosmological expansion of the universe. But we need a trick, because this signal is not enough. The idea is the following. The same prescription that we do for the shift to remap from observer, the frame of observer to the CMB frame. Instead, we can do artificial shift, also large enough, also for different directions. And then you see a remap this new distribution of the objects and reconstruct using a new definition alpha, let me say alpha artificial, the distribution and the expansion of the universe. This is what we did. This is the standard what I pointed out before. This is definition, super standard definition of the redshift correction. And then this is the delta artificial. We have the velocity of the observer, the standard one, and the artificial one. In the artificial one, when you do the shift with just only peculiar with the redshift, we have an extra term. This is alpha c that I called here. And yeah, we have this new term. Okay. Here, for example, we consider two cases. One case is related to H alpha survey, more or less is Euclid. And the second one, for example, is H1, for example, SKA. And then what we did is, for example, measure the velocity of the server, measure cosmological parameters, and then give you some example. This is the constraint, the velocity of the observer. This is the all box that we consider is 140. Okay? There are very huge boxes. And the pretty thing that this blue line is the error from Planck, that in principle is very small. Using this prescription, our errors is the same order. This is not trivial at all. And using this prescription, we're able to reconstruct the V0. This is another way to see the wind in the sky and the shift of the velocity of the observer, and then reconstruct the directions. Another pretty thing, as I said, is to model. We have different models. For example, lambda CDM with different omega app today. Or, for example, to change omega m and w dark energy, the equation state of the dark energy. Here, that is the first case. Then you see that we can construct very well omega m. Again, this is related to Planck. And the errors are the same order. Instead, here, this is the case for w and omega m. Using a smart function, we're able to have a more thin bin. That's it. This is one possible, because in general, without this artificial shift, we don't have this huge sigma to noise. Instead, using this prescription, this is a very nice way to construct the universe at very large scales in totally completely different way with using completely different setup. This is not trivial.
Thank you very much, Daniele. So now time for questions. Sandro.
You have to excuse my very naive question. Since you were mentioning about this error bar, I was thinking these corrections you do, how sensitive is your result with respect to the corrections? You would change slightly the parameter.
We did also this stuff. For example, when we do the artificial shift, we reach until 3 times the velocity of the server. We cannot do more. Because the errors of the redshift is smaller, and then you cannot have a correct. And then we also need to consider also, for example, we made all the checks. But the point is that we use the marks, and then we cannot add the errors. And of course, we need to add maybe also, of course, errors for my imputation and evolution bias, of course. But the sigma to noise, yeah.
So it's not very sensitive to what we're actually doing. This is the patient.
No. If you see that, I'll be safe. At very large scales. See, it's huge, the errors. But the idea, this is the reason why that we, for example, we use the artificial in order to shift, and then we are able to disentangle. This is one of the reasons.
So, impact caused with various limited map, let's assume that this meeting takes place in 2050. How
big the effect will be? Is already, because we use the integral constraint. And then we have under control all these effects. Also.
So this will be taking the first time?
Yes, yes, we consider also this effect. Is here.
So this will be like, if you have the, you know, what I'm saying is that now you have a survey with the, all the galaxies.
Yes, exactly.
That's the effect.
Si,
si, so
si,
it will
si.
Be like if you...
Si, 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 si.
And then the other question is that this will be a test of the air.
For example, this is a pretty thing.
This is a theory that we have never extrapolated to 10 to the 27 centimeters, right? And it has been tested on solar scales, maybe on galaxy scales, right? But never on the horizon. So this is like a crucial test of the
earth. Exactly, exactly.
Completely away from the smaller scale that we have used. But this, I think, is very important.
Very important point.
You know, that here in cosmology, you have the gear test that is completely inaccessible by instruments.
Exactly. I totally agree with
the data coming, the data there, and as you already say, so there are issues, you know, to be careful, but okay, this is a question for people to work with. And, you know, the data
this
is coming already, as you speak.
Exactly, exactly. And this is the reason why that I need to advertise a lot.
No, no, I think it's very exciting also for the students, you know, that want to work with this. And
open, we are open.
I think it's a crucial thing to test here.
Agreed.
On the horizons, on the current horizons.
Let me stress an important point. Here, in order to have 140 MOCs, we need to, our huge boxes, 6 gigaparsec for, but we are considering a field level. At a particular level, I'm working with a student, and we use the real catalog and add the GR correction galaxy per galaxy. This is another challenging stuff. Huh?
Angelo, yeah, it's more related to would you be able to distinguish this from the modified
catalog? Here, we set with 2 parameters. And then if you have 2 Maroon parameters, I think it's doable.
Other questions? If not, let's thank Daniele again. So tonight we have the social dinner at Conmubio at 20, so we either meet directly there or who wants, we meet in front of Hotel San Michele.